All right, Coach App and Brandon Arnold for Williams. Coach, congratulations on the tremendous season, even though it ended, I'm sure, prematurely or earlier than we would have liked. Opening thoughts.
First off, you know, thanks for Gilbert for hosting. It's great to get down here. We got, you know, former assistants, former players from North Carolina, current players from North Carolina. So it's great to get down amongst a lot of families and alumni and have such great support. You know, congrats to Christopher Newport on advancement. It's a great program. We've seen him now a couple times in this tournament. You know, and always following Coach Record's doing. So, you know, we knew this was going to be, you know, kind of a defensive, grinded out game. And
exactly what it was.
Exactly what it was. And we were fighting. And, you know, just kind of couldn't string together a couple stops and then made buckets, you know, down the stretch. This group's been in that situation a lot this year when we're, I think, down two with seven minutes left, but Hudson had three, and, you know, maybe even less than that. Dogs aren't in because, you know, we've closed those out and found our way so many times, but so is Christopher Newport. Again, I think the game went sort of how we were thinking. We wish we were taking care of the ball a little bit more and, you know, knocked down some open shots in the second half, but it's a testament to Coach Corin and Christopher Newport do.
Real tight first half, 30-28 at the break. What was your message to your team at halftime?
I think we came out a little high strung, a little you know, anxious maybe. But we settled into the game and, you know, really thought we did a lot, especially on the defensive end that we had talked about them. I thought we rebounded against a great rebounding team, as well as we have all season. So really just wanted to kind of tighten a few things up. We talked about how they were guarding us and some things we could do to, you know, try to create any shots against that. But we just want to keep, we thought we gave them, you know, 6 to 8 easy points on offensive decisions, and if we could tighten that up and play with the same intensity. In a 2-point game at halftime in the Sweet 16, that's kind of typical, and I got to go through it the last 20 minutes. And, up to the last 5-6 minutes, I thought we were right there, and credit to Christopher Newport.
Brandon, in a game where your team as a whole had some trouble shooting from the field, you went 2 of 2, 8 points, third on the team in scoring. What was working for you out there?
My philosophy on the court is kind of just doing what I'm good at and trying to, you know, be my best at that. And that honestly doesn't even include scoring. That's mostly kind of defense and rebounding. But I knew kind of I had to bring a certain aggressiveness that you know, I thought we were lacking in certain areas. So whether that be driving to the basket or shooting wide open three. And that was kind of just my goal, kind of just do what I'm good at and do what I can for the team.
You guys won on the glass, 42-38. But Christopher Newport did a lot of good work in the paint, outscoring you guys 26-8. How did that come about? You know, that balance of winning the rebounding, but then winning in on the interior.
Yeah, that's, you know, obviously how they really kind of put pressure on your defense to get into the paint and have guys that can make plays in there. I thought at times we're, you know, showed the discipline we wanted to in terms of, you know, getting them to where we can, staying down. Not bailing them out with fouls, but obviously the game got on, you know, whether fatigue or the moment. And then on the other end, you know, I thought we got the ball in there at times, but how they were guarding us, they, you know, had one kind of guy roaming around to really clog the paint. So, you know, so when you got it in there, it wasn't the easiest shot all the time. So, you know, that's where you got to be willing to kick it out and keep the ball moving. And I think we did that at times. You know, they do a great job of just, you know, flying around, so we get some turnovers. You know, I thought we created some open shots, you know, that just kind of went in and out in that second half. That would have either, you know, kept us in fighting distance or, you know, kind of stopped one of their runs.
Brandon, Coach mentioned to you kind of a little bit of a homecoming back down here to North Carolina for you. What was it like playing, you know, more or less, North Carolina's a big state, but kind of more in your backyard than Williamsburg, Mass.
Yeah, Yeah, I mean, it was fun. It was nice. I mean, even just getting down here, like, having the option to get certain food, like Bojangles or Cookout. That was kind of our like, first thing we did as soon as we got down here. It was nice. I mean, the weather's better. It was nice seeing kind of had some old age teammates, high school friends here. So it was really nice when we had the kind of the mindset of, you know, not losing North Carolina and then kind of taking care of business. Obviously, it didn't work out that way, but it still feels good to kind of come home and finish it here if anything. So.
In Williamsburg, in Williamstown, of course. You know that from the New England area. Show them around a little bit, North Carolina, what it's all like at down here.
We haven't done too much. I showed a lot of the teammates Cookout yesterday, though. So that was kind of my, like, showing them around. But yeah, I mean, we haven't really done too much.
Back to the game a little bit. Really strong contingent of Ephs fans came on down, made the trip down. Lots of people out here. You said that there's a pretty strong alumni base down here. What was it like playing in front of them, seeing how they traveled?
Yeah, this is my 9th season as the head coach, and been fortunate to play in the NCAA tournament a few times. And I think the most rewarding part on top of these guys just kind of creating these lifelong memories and moments together is the text messages, the emails, just the reminders of how many people are actually following this group of student athletes, and to get to another region and see that support. I think it's more of a testament to the young men we have on our team. We have 5 seniors that Brandon's kind of represented right now, but that are all great young men from California, Ohio, North Carolina, Connecticut, Mass. And, they are people, young men that people that meet them want to support them. So that group that started kind of following this ride and January is just tuning in and watch them win the regular season and this guy get to the finals, get a couple of big wins and then to the tournament to get to the second weekend. As I said, I think it's always just a prideful moment to remember who we represent. And also I think speaks a lot about the young men we have in our program and how people rally around them because they're worth rallying around.
Thoughts about heading into next year. I know it's too early. I wanted to focus on tonight, but what are your thoughts on this group heading into next year?
I learned a lot about last year, not looking too forward. I mean, we lost last year in the second round because of injuries. We started junior 4 underclassmen and thought it was going to be smooth sailing heading into this year with our experience. A few of those guys are out injured. New guys stepped up. So I'm proud of the program we have with Christopher Newport. They had a bunch of first year playing and still find themselves in the NBA now. I think we showed the depth and the commitment to winning that we have in our program. So we're going to miss bigger classes, who's 5 seniors, they are, put those 5 up in terms of personalities and versatility on the basketball court against any group. So it'll be a much different feel, much different group. I mean, Brandon, Nate Karen, and Cole Brown Smith have essentially played every game they were healthy for the last 3 years. Sam Dallas not that we missed last season, but it's 4 guys that played basically every game they're helping people for multiple years. So kind of a little different, but
Brandon,
really proud of these guys and excited for the guys coming up to assume more leadership and roles.
Brandon, you were in the gym with them every day. What are your thoughts?
I'm excited for them. Like, they have a really strong team, really ambitious, really kind of ready to go at it. Even after today's loss, there's a few minutes where guys hang their head, and then after that, it's kind of just all love, and everyone's kind of looking forward to what's next. So I'm excited. It definitely will be kind of a different scene and different personalities with us leaving, but I look forward to kind of being able to support where I can. And even in the crowd today, we had guys that were graduated from
to appreciate the well run weekend. It's always a great tournament. We're incredibly proud of what we do in the last 16, wish you were more. But our other school, that's always just really cool.
All right. Congrats on a strong season again. Safe travels back.
Thanks so much.